Hello. From Hastings, Nebraska, this is Fritz Mountford welcoming you to Christmas at Hastings College, a celebration in words and music from a festival of nine lessons and carols. At Hastings College, choral singing at Christmas is a long tradition dating to the college's 1882 founding on the Nebraska prairie. By the end of the 19th century, the Hastings College Choir was already well known through tours of the region by train and over still unpaved roads for an eclectic repertoire. In that tradition, this service too incorporates elements from a variety of sources. We'll be singing familiar 19th century hymns and carols, of course, this year with an emphasis on six centuries of American and English Christmas songs. For instance, you'll hear a familiar text from Handel's Messiah, but in a contemporary American setting. At Hastings College, our continuing series of holiday performances of Messiah began in the 1920s. In the 1930s, the national magazine The Etude featured a Christmas Eve service of words and music by the Hastings College Choir, which served as a model for similar celebrations around the country. Now it is another moonlit December night on the prairie. The college community has gathered, and beginning with the invocation, O come, Emmanuel, the Hastings College Choir will lead the congregation to consider once again the true meaning and spirit of Christmas. Welcome, and enjoy a festival of nine lessons and carols from Hastings College.
Oh. Abraham built an altar and laid the wood in order and bound Isaac, his son, and laid him on the altar. Then he reached out his hand and took the knife to slay his son. But the angel of the Lord called out to him from heaven, "Do not lay a hand on the boy. I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you have not withheld your son, your only son, I will surely bless you and make your descendants as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand which is on the seashore. And because you have obeyed my voice, through your descendants shall all the nations of the earth be blessed."
Of the Father's love begotten, and the world began to be, he is Alpha and Omega, he the source, the ending. All the things that are that have been, and that future ye shall see, evermore and
oh! foretells the coming of a Savior. For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, a great darkness over the people. But the Lord shall arise upon you, and the glory of the Lord shall be seen over you, and the nations shall come to your light, and rulers to the brightness of your dawning. There shall come forth a shoot from the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of its roots. The Spirit of the Lord will rest upon that branch, the Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the Spirit of counsel and of power, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the goat, and the calf and the lion and the yearling together, and a little child will lead them. The cow will feed with the bear, their young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as waters cover the sea. Arise, shine, for your light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you.
Tells the glory of humble Bethlehem, birthplace of a ruler who will usher in a reign of peace and justice. But you, O Bethlehem, though you are small among the cities of Judah, out of you will come one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And his people will live securely, for then his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth, and he will be their peace.
Thank you.
angel Gabriel announces to Mary that she will give birth to God's promised one. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin, pledged to be married to a man whose name was Joseph, a descendant of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came to her and said, "Hail, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." And when she saw the angel, Mary was greatly troubled at these words and wondered what manner of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Fear not, Mary, for you have been found favor with God. Behold, you will be with child and give birth to a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and shall be greatly exalted, the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will never end."
As is the rose that blossoms. whose name shall be called Jesu, Nova, Nova, Nova,
Nova, Nova, Ave Fides ex Eva, Nova, Nova, Ave Fides ex Eva.
And said the maiden, verily, I am your servant right truly, Ecce Angela Domini, Nova, Nova, Nova,
Nova, Nova, Ave Fides ex Eva, Nova.
And it came to pass in those days there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, every one to their own cities. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the city of David, because he belonged to the house and lineage of David. He went to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, who was great with child. And so it was, while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should deliver. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
The stars in the bright sky.
the shepherds, los pastores, go to see the Savior of the world, el Salvador del mundo, lying in the manger. Y ahí pastores en la misma tierra, que velaban y guardaban las vigilas de la noche sobre su ganado. Y aquí el ángel del Señor vino sobre ellos, y la claridad de Dios los acercó al resplandor, y tuvieron gran temor. Mas el ángel les dijo, no temáis, porque he aquí os doy nuevas de gran gozo, que será para todo el pueblo, que os ha nacido hoy en la ciudad de David un Salvador, que es Cristo el Señor. Y esto os será la señal, hallaréis al niño envuelto en pañales, echado en un pesebre. Y repentinamente fue con el ángel una multitud de ejércitos celestiales que alababan a Dios y decían, gloria en las alturas a Dios y en la tierra paz a hombres que ama el Señor. Y entonces cuando los ángeles se fueron, los pastores dijeron unos a otros, pasemos pues hasta Belén y veamos esto que ha sucedido, que el Señor ahora se ha manifestado. Y vinieron a prisa y hallaron a María y a José y al niño acostado en un pesebre.
The Magi follow a star to find the child Jesus.
Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of Herod the king, behold, there came magi from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is the one who has been born king of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him. When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had gathered all the chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born. And they said to him, In Bethlehem, in Judea, for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people Israel. And lo, the star they had seen in the east went before them, until it came and stood over the place where the child was. And when they came into the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Oh,
John unfolds the great mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The Word was with God at the beginning, and all things came into being through the Word. Not one thing came into being without the Word. What has come into being in the Word is life, and the light was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has never overcome it. There was someone sent from God, whose name was John, who came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through John. John himself was not the light, but came to testify to the light. The true light, which gives light to everyone, was even then coming into the world. And the Word became flesh and dwells among us. Thanks be to God. Amen.
As you hear from our exuberant friends and fans, we've reached the conclusion of another festival of nine lessons and carols. The chapel organist is Phil Clay. The Hastings College Choir, now in our 133rd year, is accompanied by Ruth Moore. Thanks to Bart Jones and Sharon Brooks of HC World Media, who engineered and produced the live simulcast of this year's festival. The college chaplain is Reverend Damon Heitman. With technical assistance from Tyler Donovan and Mason Lindblom, special thanks to Rogine Short, who for 30 years has facilitated this production in French Memorial Chapel. I hope you have enjoyed a festival of nine lessons and carols. For the faculty, staff, and students of Hastings College, this is Fritz Mountford wishing you all the blessings of the season. Thanks for listening.